嗨，弟兄姐妹，主里平安，很高兴再次的见到你。欢迎你再次回到美加书邦的线上崇拜。今天是圣餐主日，让我们预备我们的心来纪念主耶稣在十字架为我们流出的宝血。你预备好了吗？让我以下这段的经文来开始今天的崇拜。经文取自于诗篇47篇1至2节。万民啊，你们都要拍掌，要用夸声的声音向神呼喊，因为耶和华至高者是可畏的，他是治理全地的大君王。让我们以诗歌来敬拜我们的上帝。
大家好，让我们一起来拍手赞美我们的上帝。 Thank you.
弟兄姐妹，让我们做一个祷告。亲爱的天父上帝，孩子们来到你的面前，我们要献上敬拜赞美的声音，我们要献上感恩的心。这段时间，主你不断地保守我们，不受任何病毒的侵害。感谢主耶稣，道成肉身来到世上，为我们担当一切的罪。主啊，愿你祝福我们所有的弟兄姐妹，叫我们生命满有主你的怜悯与慈爱。也求主透过今天的信息，教导指引我们的道路。这样的祷告乃是奉靠主耶稣基督的名求。阿门。好，弟兄姐妹，接下来是朗读使徒信经的时候，好不好？你在家中也一起站起来好吗？好，预备好了吗？我们一二三，开始。我信上帝，全能的父，创造天地的主。我信我主耶稣基督，上帝的独生子，因圣灵感孕，由童贞尼玛利亚所生，在本丢比拉多手下受难，被钉于十字架，受死埋葬，降在阴间，第三天从死人中复活升天，坐在全能父上帝的右边，将来必从那里降临审判活人死人。我信圣灵，我信圣而公之教会，我信圣徒相通，我信罪得赦免，我信身体复活，我信永生。阿们。现在是奉献的时间，我们以敬拜的心，以感恩的心，把金钱献给主。在我们开始奉献之前，我们可以以祷告预备自己的心，以感谢的心来到主的施恩宝座前。我们可以用一段时间来向神祷告。预备好的弟兄姐妹们，可以透过荧幕上所显示的账号进行转账。现在我们一起做奉献的祷告。亲爱的主耶稣，感谢你的恩典，我们在主里是多么的蒙福，我们也愿意把自己摆上，愿主使用我们， 在主你的福音上有份，传扬你的救恩，也求你赐给我们聪明、智慧，使用这些金钱来扩展福音的工作。这样的祷告乃是奉靠主耶稣基督的名求，阿们。欢迎回家，弟兄姐妹好吗？感谢神，我们还是一样能够透过网络一起的敬拜神。如果你是第一次参与我们网络崇拜的，我们非常欢迎你，我们也期待下个星期能够继续的看到你。现在我们一起站起来，给我一个 high five 好吗？一二三，感谢主。我要继续邀请弟兄姐妹关注我们的 Facebook 跟 Instagram， 能够得到每家书房的最新消息。接下来是一起读经的时间，今天的正道经文取自于出埃及记17:6。看啊，我要在何烈的磐石那里站在你面前，你要击打磐石，水就会从磐石流出来给百姓喝。摩西就在以色列的长老跟前这样做了。今天恩典传道要传讲的信息是磐石出水。
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，你们好吗？
Brothers and sisters in Christ, how are you?
我们的这个管制期快要50天了。
Our MCO period has slowly approached 50 days.
你们还有东西吃吗？
Do you guys still have things to eat?
你们还好吗？
Are you still okay?
我们看到人的基本需要是什么呢？
The basic needs of people, what are they?
就是食物跟水来维持我们的生命。
Food and water to preserve life.
这些基本的需要呢，也是生活中对神信心最直接的考验。
These basic needs are also a direct test of our faith by God.
上一次的讲到，我们提到以色列人在旷野没有东西吃。
Last sermon we mentioned about how the Israelites did not have food to eat in the wilderness.
上帝赐给他们玛纳来吃。
But instead, God gave them manna.
现在呢，是没有喝的水了。
Now they did not have water to drink.
这个是以色列人出了埃及以后呢，再一次遇到没有水的问题。
And this is the second time that Israelites have faced water problems since they have left Egypt.
上一次呢是在马拉那个地方。
And the previous time was at Mara.
这一次是过了2个月，在靠近西乃山的利非丁这个地方。
And 2 months later, It's at Rephidim, near Mount Sinai.
这一次呢，百姓不止发怨言啊，他们还想要拿石头打摩西耶。
The people did not only complain, but they also wanted to throw stones at Moses.
所以当摩西向上帝求助的时候，上帝说什么呢？
And when Moses asked God for help, what did God say?
在出埃及记第17:5-6，这边这样子说：耶和华对摩西说，你带着以色列的几个长老走在百姓面前，手里拿着你先前击打尼罗河的杖，去吧。
And in Exodus chapter 17:5-6, it says that, the Lord answered Moses, go out in front of the people.Take with you some of the elders of Israel, and take in your hand the staff in which you have struck now, and go.
看啊，我要在何烈的磐石那里站在你面前，你要击打磐石，水就会从磐石流出来给百姓喝。
And verse 6, I will stand there before you by the rock at Horeb. Strike the rock, and water will come out of it for the people to drink.
所以上帝指示摩西到一个磐石那边击打磐石，水就出来了。
And God instructed Moses to find a rock and hit it to make water.
这个水呢，就像河流那样子的，一直的流出来。
And the water like river keeps flowing out.
可能呢，就是接下来供应他们一整年在西乃山脚下面要喝的水。
And this could be the water to supply and to sustain them, at the foot of Mount Sinai for the next year.
上帝他常常用生活中的一些的事物来告诉人们他将要做的事。
And God often used life examples to tell the people what He would do.
就好比说，以色列人在旷野吃玛纳，对吗？
For example, the Israelites had ate manna in the wilderness.
Manna 就是预告了有一天神的儿子成为我们吃的生命的粮。
And this foretold that one day the Son of God would become the bread of life we eat.
耶稣就是生命的粮。
And Jesus is the bread of life.
这一次呢，水从磐石流出来。
And the water that flows from the rock.
那这个磐石所要预告的也是耶稣。
It is also a notice to signify Jesus.
耶稣就是那个磐石。
And Jesus is the rock.
在新约哥林多前书第十章这边这样子说。
In 1 Corinthians chapter 10, it reads.
弟兄们，我不愿意你们不知道，我们的祖宗从前都在云下，都从海中经过。
First one, for I do not want you to be ignorant of the fact, brothers and sisters, that our ancestors were all under the cloud, and that they all passed through the sea.
都在云里、海里受洗归了摩西。
And they were all baptized into Moses in the clouds and in the sea.
并且都吃了一样的灵粮
They all ate the same spiritual food.
也都喝了一样的灵水所喝的是出于跟随着他们的灵磐石那磐石就是基督
And drank the same spiritual drink for they drank from the same spiritual rock that accompanied them and that rock was Christ.
圣经说，这个磐石是跟随着他们的灵磐石，这很有意思。
And accordingly, the rock has accompanied them, and it's very meaningful.
因为在以色列人的传说当中啊，这个磐石就是一直跟着他们。
Because according to the legend of Israelites, this rock has accompanied them all this while.
而且源源不断的供应水，保罗呢就是引用这样子的一个传说。
And had supplied them with water continuously, and this is also how Paul had quoted this legend.
那我们知道呢，要在旷野40年，让200万的人喝到足够的水，是几乎不可能的。
We know that it is quite impossible to have enough water for 40 years in the wilderness for 2 million people.
除非呢，上帝一路上呢，都行磐石出水的神迹。
Unless along the way, God continuously performs the miracle of the rock.
难怪呢，传说中这个磐石就好像跟着他们一样。
No wonder legend has it that it's almost as if the rock has always accompanied them.
我们想到磐石会想到怎么样的特性呢
?When we speak of the rock, what are its characteristics?
我们就会想到它是很稳固的非常坚定的。
We think of it as solid and firm.
这个、要盖房子盖大楼的时候打地基是很重要的。
For example, when you are building a building,the piling machine is very important.
因为呢，这个地基要一直的打到地底下坚固的岩石，这个建筑物才会稳定。
Because this piling machine have to keep reinforcing its the foundation and keep going deeper and deeper until it hit a hard rock.
所以呢，一栋大楼是不是很稳固呢？不是看它外表好不好看。
So whether or not a building is stable is not by looking at its appearance.
或者是它的价钱有多少。
Or how much it is worth.
而是它有没有先把地基给打好。
But did it have a good foundation?
那一样的，我们要站稳，我们不动摇，不是因为我们有多强壮。
Similarly, we stand firm and we are not easily shaken. It's not because of how strong and how powerful we are.
也不是因为我们多英俊，而是我们站在哪里。
But and it is also not how handsome we are, but it is where we stand.
那举个例子来说，有地震的时候呢，是不容易站稳的。
For example, when there is an earthquake, it is hard to stand on your feet.
在马来西亚呢，我们其实很难经历到地震，但是我之前在台湾住的时候常常有地震。
In Malaysia, it is very unlikely to experience earthquake, but when I was in Taiwan, it happened regularly.
有时候只是感觉好像头怎么有一点晕晕的，走路好像有一点点不稳，突然发现原来是地震。
Sometimes it just feels a bit dizzy.And when you're walking, it's very unstable. But I realize it's actually an earthquake.
不过呢，很快的一下子就停了。
But very quickly, it stops.
有时候呢，还希望它可以摇久一点，享受一下。
And sometimes I even hope that it will go on a bit longer.
还好呢，这些都是小地震。如果大地震怎么办呢？
Fortunately, these are all just minor earthquake. What if it's a big earthquake?
在1990年呢，马尼拉有一个 7.7 级的大地震。
In 1990, Manila had an earthquake of magnitude of 7.7.
那时候我在那边参加大学的这个短宣队。
And during that time, I participated in...A short, my university's short mission trip.
当时呢，我记得我还在巴士上面。
And I was on a bus that time.
怎么我感觉这个司机啊，跟我们开玩笑，这个 bus 一直在左右摇晃。
And that time, I felt that the bus was playing a joke on us. It keeps steering to the left and right.
但是我后来又想一想。如果他要开玩笑的话，应该是前后摇晃啊，因为他一直踩 brake 又放，踩 brake 又放啊。
But when I think about it, if he wants to play a joke on us, it should be the driver pressing the brake and should be going forward and stop, forward and stop.
怎么会是左右摇晃呢
？How could it be left and right?
看到窗外，哇，那个电灯柱呢，大力的摇摆啊。
I look out the window and start to see the lighting pole swaying, lamppost was swaying.
然后有人还抱着那个电灯柱。
And some people were even holding onto them.
这个时候呢，大家才喊出来，哇，是地震。
And this time everyone shouted, earthquake.
很多的建筑物在那一次的大地震中倒下来了。
At that time, many buildings fell during the earthquake.
我们知道，当大地不稳的时候，没有东西能够站立得住。
We know that when the earth is unstable, it is very hard for building to stand firm.
所以，当圣经说耶稣是磐石，这给我们心中很大的安定。
And when the Bible says that Jesus is our rock, this gives us a great assurance.
他永远不动摇。
He can never waver.
他也要教会建立在这个磐石上面。
And he wants our church to be built upon the rock.
而死亡的权柄呢，就不能够胜过教会。
Where death could not overcome the church.
在马太福音16:18，这边这样说。
In Matthew chapter 16 verse 18.
我要把我的教会建造在这磐石上，阴间的权柄。不能胜过他。
On this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it.
弟兄姐妹们，你要站稳吗
？Brothers and sisters, do you want to stand firm?
你要问回你自己，你的根基在哪里
？Ask yourself, where is your foundation?
在这一次的病毒的这个疫情中，我们的心思啊，是被这个小小的病毒所充满。
During this time of pandemic, our mind seems to be filled with this little virus.
我们是需要小心的留意这个病毒疫情的发展，但是呢，好像这个资讯呢是太多了。
We must be careful and pay attention to development of this virus, COVID-19. But it seems like there are too much information.
比如说，新闻除了跟病毒有关的报道，其他的没有了。
For example, our news is only about the virus and nothing else.
比如说，哪一个巴萨有谁中了这个，得了这个病毒？大家就讨论啊，有谁过去过那个地方
？And whichever market is affected by this coronavirus, people will discuss about it.
比如说，有人讲你什么特效药呢？大家就快点去试一试。
For example, when someone mentioned a special type of medicine, people will start to try it.
就连美国总统开玩笑的这个消毒水啊，都有人相信他嘞。
Even when President Trump joke about bleach, some people even believed it.
所以我们看到人们站不稳啊。
So we see that people are not standing firm.
他们在不安，在慌张，甚至在迷失当中。
They are restless. They are in panic. They are lost.
在信主之后。在你面对大挑战的时候，你有什么心态，有什么不同吗
？After you believed in Jesus, what is the difference in your mentality when you are facing a big challenge?
我们知道教会的根基是磐石耶稣基督。
We know that the church foundation is on the rock, which is Jesus Christ.
让我们回到他的面前来敬拜他。
Let us come before him and to worship him.
让我们也纪念他为我们做的牺牲。
And let us also remember the sacrifices he had made.
他为了拯救我们，他被打，被人背叛，被挂在十字架上。
Because in order to save us, he was beaten, he was hung on the cross.
那我们看到，在摩西使磐石出水的时候，他要击打这个磐石。
We see that Moses had hit the rock when he needed water.
那就涌出很多的水来。
And water flew out from it.
这里的击打呢，不是摸一下或者是轻轻拍一下哦。
It is not merely to gently hit it.
是击打 strike 是用力的打，就好像啊一招要把它打死那样。
But to strike the rock hard.
所以当然我们知道呢，人呢是不可能用这个棒啊这个杖呢把这个大岩石给打裂的。
We probably know that it is very unlikely that Moses will use the staff to hit the rock.
更何况呢，它是应该是很巨大的一个磐石。
Even what so even more is that the rock is a very huge rock.
从圣经我们看到呢，上帝要摩西带着以色列的长老去到一个何烈的磐石那里。
And God wanted Moses to bring the elders to Horeb.
那 that's the rock in Horeb， 在那个在何烈的磐石那里，它不是随随便便的一个磐石。
It's the rock in Horeb. It is not just an ordinary rock.
所以那个应该是相当大而且特殊的一个磐石。
It should be
靠近何烈山，就是西乃山。
It should be a pretty big and a special rock near Mount Helia, which is now Mount Sinai.
在传统上面呢，西乃山的地点呢，被都认为在西乃半岛。
Traditionally, Mount Sinai was considered to be in Sinai Peninsula.
但是近年来呢，有一些人提出摩西上的这个山啊，可能是在阿拉伯半岛。
But in recent years, it was suggested that probably it's near Arabian Peninsula.
所以他们去考察发现呢，不止那边有像圣经所形容的那个山，还有呢那个大磐石。
And after the investigation, they found out that, indeed there was the big and huge rock over there.
那我对这个磐石是很有兴趣的，当然呢还没有证明哦，那个就是那个磐石。
Of course, I'm very interested in this rock, but even though it's not confirmed yet.
它是很巨大，而且呢中间好像被水冲开的一个磐石。
It is huge.And it's almost like in the middle of it, it's almost as if it's been washed away by water.
所以我们看到这个照片里面呢，从比例来看呢，这个磐石至少有十几层楼高啊。
And from this picture, we can see that the rock is almost as high as 10 stories.
当然，我们知道地点在哪里不是最重要的。
And of course, the location is not important.
因为旧约预告中真正的磐石已经出现了。
Because the real stone in Old Testament has already appeared.
就是耶稣本身呢。
Which is Jesus Christ.
耶稣就像这个磐石，甘心被击打。
Jesus is like the stone willing to be beaten.
他被门徒所背叛。
Betrayed by his disciples.
他的身体破开，流出生命的宝血。
His body was broke open and flows out is the life of his precious blood.
他为了建立他的教会，他放下他的生命。
In order to build the church, he had laid down his life.
使我们得着新的生命。
So that we can have a new life.
他是磐石，流出生命的活水来。
He is the stone that flows out living water.
所以在诗篇的作者就也曾经预言这件事情。
And the author of Psalms had predicted.
在诗篇118篇22节那边说。
In the book of Psalms, chapter 118, verse 22.
匠人所丢弃的石头已成了房角的头块石头。
The stone and the builders rejected has become the cornerstone.
这个石头已经成了上帝的家的房角石。
Now this stone has become the cornerstone of the house of God.
它建立了上帝的家。
And it had built the house of God.
让世界各地各民各族的人成为家人。
So that the people of all ethnic groups can become a member of the family.
就像保罗在以弗所书第二章十九二十节所说的
，Like how Paul said in Ephesians 2 chapter 19 to 20，
这样你们不再是外人或客旅，是与圣徒同国，是神家里的人啦。
Consequently, you are no longer foreigners and strangers, but fellow citizens with God's people and also member of His household.
被建造在使徒和先知的根基上，而基督耶稣自己为房角石。
Built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone.
耶稣不只建立了神的家，他也要我们成为建造神的家的一份子。
Jesus not only built the house of God, but he also wants us to be part of it.
他要我们成为那个活的石头来建造神的家。
He wants us to be the living stones to build the house of God.
我们是上帝家的活石。
We are the living stones of the house of God.
在彼得前书第二章四到五节这边说。
In 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 4 to 5.
他说要亲近主，他是活石。虽然被人丢弃，却是神所拣选、所珍贵的。
As you come to him, the living stone, rejected by humans, but chosen by God and precious to him.
你们作为活石，要被建造成为属灵的殿，成为圣洁的祭司，借着耶稣基督献上神悦纳属灵的祭物。
You also, like living stones, are being built into a spiritual house to be holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ.
弟兄姐妹们，不管你怎么样看待你自己，
Brothers and sisters, no matter how you look at yourself,
你是上帝要使用的活石。
You are someone that God wants to use.
你是活的，是可以跟人有互动的。
You're a living person, and you can have a relationship and fellowship with one another.
我们可以有彼此的团契，可以彼此的关心的。
And we can care for one another and have fellowship.
在这一段的管制期里面，我们没有办法真的见面，对吗？
During this MCO period, it is very hard for us to meet up.
那我要请大家继续的在你的小组中跟大家好好的联络。
And I urge everyone to put some effort to commit with your life group.
因为我们是活的，要彼此的联络的。
Because we are living and we have to keep connecting.
让我们回到磐石。
Let's go back to the rock.
让我们领受从耶稣而来的活水。
Let us receive the living God.
让我们为主而活吧。
And live for the Lord.
我们的崇拜呢，不一定要有很多的花招。
Our worship don't need a lot of, don't need pattern.
我们不是要来看表演啊，或者来听一场什么创意的演讲。
We are not here to watch live performance or some creative things.
我们在一起崇拜是要来敬拜真神。
We are here to worship our Lord.
如果根基不在呢，这些上面再好看的东西有一天也都会掉下来的。
If the foundation is not good, no matter how it looks, it will still fall one day.
所以让我们回到我们信仰的根本吧。
So let us return to the root of faith.
我们一次又一次的认定耶稣就是那磐石。
And to continuously affirm that Jesus is that rock.
他永不动摇。
And he will never waver.
让我们来信靠他。
Let us believe in him.
让我们来敬拜他。
Let us worship him.
让我们来跟随他。
And let us follow him.
等一下我们会有这个线上的这个圣餐。
So, later we will have Holy Communion.
那这个圣餐其实就是让我们一次又一次的回到耶稣我们的磐石这边。
And this Holy Communion is for us to go back, return to Christ.
他是我们信仰的根基。
And he is the root of our faith.
所以在这个圣餐里面呢，我们要来一起的做一些的宣认，一些的宣告。
In this communion, we want to proclaim our faith.
是的，我们宣认我们所相信的耶稣是我们的救主。
We want to proclaim that Jesus is our Savior.
他被击打，他被丢弃，他被杀害，是为了要把生命的活水给我们。
He was beaten, he was hurt, he was forsaken.So that he may give us this living water.
在这个圣餐里面呢，我们也要好好的来和好。
And in this Holy Communion, we also want to reconcile.
与人、与神、与人来和好。
To reconcile with God and reconcile with people.
如果我们在过去犯了罪，我们有做错的地方，我们要向上帝来承认。
If previously we have sinned, we want to come before God and confess.
如果这段时间里面你发了很多的脾气，你要向上帝来认罪悔改。
If you had a bad temper during this period, please come before God and confess and repent.
并且呢，与人来和好。
And to reconcile with people.
然后呢，圣餐也表达了我们对上帝的倚靠。
And this also shows our trust in God.
让我们在它里面站稳，面对前面的道路吧。
and for us to be stronger in our future endeavors.
我们要非常谢谢 Timothy 为我们的翻译。
Thank
you, brother.
Thank you.
我们一起来祷告。
Now let us pray.
亲爱的天父啊，谢谢你与我们同在。你一次一次的在告诉我们，你是我们可信靠的对象，你永不改变，你是磐石，而且你源源不断的要赐下生命的活水在所有信靠你的人的身上。我们感谢你，我们同时也要来到你的面前，为着我们有这样子的机会来以圣餐纪念这一位你所爱的儿子为我们做的牺牲。他是磐石，他是生命的粮，他是生命的活水，如今白白的赐给了我们。我们要一起的来纪念耶稣基督被击打，被背叛，被钉在十字架上，受苦流血，为要拯救我们。感谢你给我们这个恩典，一次又一次的回到我们信仰的根基，回到耶稣基督我们的磐石上。奉耶稣基督的名，我们祷告的，阿们。亲爱的弟兄姊妹们，让我们一起的来预备心，来领受圣餐。虽然是现在我们各自在不同的家里，但我们灵里是合一的。愿上帝在这一次的圣餐当中，把丰厚的恩典，把丰盛与他的经历赐给我们。让我们存着感恩的心，与大家在圣餐中与神团契。全能的父，创造天地的主，我们无论在何时何地都要感谢你，这本是应当的，也是美好喜乐的。你照你的形象创造我们，又把生命气息吹进我们里面。当我们背叛你，失去爱你的心时，你的爱却永不改变。你拯救我们脱离捆锁，与我们立约，成为我们至高的上帝，并借着先知晓谕我们。因此我们和你地上的万民以及所有天上的会众一同称颂尊奉主有荣耀的圣名，不住赞美主说。让我们一起来，圣哉圣哉圣哉，能力与威严的大主宰，天地充满你的荣耀，高高在上何撒那，那奉主名来的是应当称颂的，高高在上何撒那。全能的父，你是至圣的，你的儿子耶稣基督是应当称颂的。你以圣灵膏他，去传福音给贫穷的人，宣告被掳的得释放，瞎眼的得看见，叫那受压制的得自由，并宣告拯救百姓的日子已来到。你要拯救你自己的子民，他医治病者，使饥饿的得饱足，并与罪人同席，借着他的受苦受死与复活，你建立了你的教会，把我们从罪恶与死亡的捆锁中释放出来，并以水与圣灵与我们立了新约。当主耶稣升天时，他应许在你真道与圣灵的大能中常与我们同在。主耶稣被卖的那一夜，他拿起饼来，祝谢了，掰开，递给门徒说：“你们拿着吃，这是我的身体，为你们舍的。” 你们都要如此行，为的是纪念我。饭后，他又拿起杯来，祝谢了，递给门徒说：你们都要喝，这是我立新约的血，为你们免罪流的。你们每逢喝的时候，要如此行，为的是纪念我。因此我们纪念你在耶稣基督里大能的作为，我们要在赞美与感谢中献上自己，作为圣洁的活祭，与基督为我们所献上的祭联合，共同宣扬信仰的奥秘。让我们一起的来回应，预备来。基督曾经死了，基督已经复活，基督必要再来。求你将你的圣灵浇灌在我们当中，也浇灌在所贡献的饼与杯上。当我们领受时，就犹如领受基督的身体与宝血，使我们因宝血的救赎，在世人面前成了基督的身体。求你借着你的灵，使我们与基督合一，我们也彼此合一，并以合一的心侍奉世人，直到服侍世人，直到主基督最后胜利降临，我们与他共赴天上的圣宴。全能的父，借着你的儿子耶稣基督，并在圣教会中的圣灵，所有的权柄与荣耀都归于你，从今时直到永远。阿们。让我们同心的来诵读主祷文。我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们陷入试探，救我们脱离那恶者。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的，直到永远。阿们。这个时候，就让我们一起的来吃着圣餐。我要先请家里面的爸爸或者是妈妈，把这个圣餐饼发给孩子们。如果你是一个人，你也可以自己拿起这圣餐的饼。发给大家以后，我要请你做一个祷告，感谢上帝的祷告，就可以吃了。过后呢，也一样是拿起这杯来，如果是一个杯，给大家轮流着喝；如果是分成不同的杯，你发给每一个人一个杯，做一个感恩的祷告，也可以喝这杯。我们有一段的时间，让大家各自在家里领受圣餐。
This is my body given for you. This is the cup that holds the blood of a new covenant. This is forgiveness, simple and true.This is the way that I have made for you. Before you eat, before you drink, take a long look inside and tell me what you see. He said, Do this in remembrance of me.Before you eat and do this in remembrance of me.
让我们一起的来祷告。亲爱的天父，我们感谢你，就在这样子一个特别的环境中，我们领受着圣餐。我们知道你与我们同在，你的爱子为我们的牺牲，为我们所流出的宝血，谢谢你拯救了我们。我们如今身为你的教会，我们要在这世上继续的跟随你，继续的要以我们的生命活出耶稣新生命的样式。求你赐我们能力，在这时候我们也为着每一个家庭，每一个会友们，亲戚朋友们来祷告，与我们都深刻的经历你的同在，你的恩典，尤其是在这样子的一个病毒疫情的当中，我们求你拯救这世界，拯救更多的灵魂。奉耶稣的名我们祷告，阿们。
报告的时间，我们欢迎新朋友到我们的 Facebook 网站留言，好让我们能够认识你。 如果你刚才的奉献是十一奉献、按月奉献或建堂奉献，请你把收据发给荧幕上所显示的电话号码，又或者是电邮到我们的美高书房的 email。 投资天国的事业在新堂筹款的进度目前已达到930千，我们感谢主，鼓励弟兄姐妹继续为这事情祷告，我们愿意委身在当中。下个主日的讲员是何师母，期待大家在线上继续的一起崇拜。愿耶和华赐福给你，保护你，愿耶和华使他的脸光照你，赐恩给你，愿耶和华向你扬眼，赐你平安。弟兄姐妹继续在小组透过 WhatsApp 或者是 Zoom Group Chat 分享今天的题目或彼此代祷，愿神祝福大家。